You raise them up so they can take off.
Okay.
Channel, guys. I am coming at you with a new hairdo. I just got back from my hair appointment and I tried to film a little bit of it and I made a little vlog about it. So I don't know if it will be up before or after this video, but if it is and you want to know how I got my hair looking so good, go check it out. But I hope you guys are all doing well and welcome back to the channel. I am starting this vlog off as a last week in San Diego. I am home in my parents' house in Del Mar, and it is my last week at home before I move permanently to the UK. And it's just a whirlwind of emotions, guys. I don't really know how else to explain it, but yeah, I just can't believe that in less than 2 weeks, I will be moving to a whole new country and finally reunited with George. It's definitely bittersweet. I am extremely, extremely close to my family, and my parents and my brother all live here in San Diego. So this week is jam-packed with family time. I'm gonna be hanging out with my brother, going out to brunch with my brother. I'm trying to pack in as many beach days as possible. Thankfully it's sunny this week and it's my last week, so I'm so happy about that. It's also Passover and my family is half Jewish, so we will be celebrating Passover the next 2 or 3 nights. I have a lot of family, and since we have gone nearly a whole year without seeing one another, this is kind of like our Thanksgiving or time just to get together. The majority of my whole family is fully vaccinated now, which is great, and so it'll be really nice to be able to actually hug my family members and spend time with them before I move. So I just wanted to kick off this intro, this vlog in my house in Del Mar, and tell you that I'm really excited to see what I get up to this week. It's a really busy week. I have a lot of last minute packing to do. Like I said, I just got my hair done. Just like little things here and there to check off my list. I also have a few just like regular appointments, a facial, and other things. Yeah, I just wanted to kick off the vlog here and say that I'm really excited for this week. Like I said, it's super bittersweet, but I'm sure that I will be back soon to visit my family. I know my dad is like low-key a little upset, which I understand. His baby girl's leaving and I'm moving to a whole new country, so it's definitely gonna be an adventure. Anyways, I really hope you guys enjoy this week's vlog. It'll be a really great week to see what I get up to here in San Diego with my family before I move to England. Guys, my brother's here.
Hello. What's up, guys?
I love him so much. Do you miss me?
I miss you. I haven't seen you in so long. My hair looks crazy.
Let's check ourselves out.
I look like Jack Sparrow.
How do I look?
Dude, look at my receding hairline. I look like
an old man. Oh, I have one too. Wait, we're twins. Look, mine.
How sad is that?
Okay. So, I'm just going to do a little question and answer for the vlog since your sister is moving to London.
I know.
And you're going to...
It's exciting.
You're excited for me?
Mm-hmm.
Are you going to visit?
Yeah, of course.
Oh,
I'm very excited to visit.
Okay.
Drink some pints.
Okay, what are you looking forward to most about England?
Ooh, going out to some clubs, drinking some pints, seeing the Queen.
Think you're gonna meet the Queen? Okay. Guys, I am on my way to go pick up my brother. I'm in my bikini. I am going to go get breakfast with him this morning since it's like one of my last few days here in San Diego, or like last week. I wanted to just spend some quality time with my family. My brother lives in Encinitas in his own little apartment, so I don't get to see him as much when I'm living back at home, but we're pretty close now, I would say. We're 2 years apart. He's 2 years younger than me. It's like every sibling relationship, I feel like we used to fight a lot when we were younger, and we're finally at that age where we have definitely matured a lot, and we're more now friends than enemies, I guess you could say. Definitely, we've both been through a lot together throughout our life, and so I definitely love him a lot. I'm super proud of him. He's a lifeguard here in San Diego and training to get his like EMT school, so he's been really working hard on that, and I'm super, super proud of him. Anyways, I hardly get to spend time with him, and we are relatively close, like I said, so I'm super, super excited to get some breakfast with him this morning. So anyways, I'm gonna go and pick up my brother and head to breakfast. I think we're gonna go get acai bowls, but I'm not sure, so let's go see what we do.
Almighty.
Gonna get some breakfast.
What's up, guys?
What's up, guys? Happy Sunday.
Happy.
Welcome to the
vloggy.
Vlog.
Getting us a boat in Cabo. We even talked to the guy. I'm like, oh, no. And then I'm like, wait. I caught up a giant train.
Why all my homies.
I tell you to come out with me every night.
We moved to the sunshine because it was too cold over there.
That is what it is.
Show them what you got, dude.
I got a little Eggs Benedict action.
Max got Eggs Benedict.
You know what I'm saying? A little hash brown action.
Hash browns. And I got half a Benedict and half an acai bowl, which is pretty fire.
Pretty fire. Pretty
flame
gas.
Fire. This is my beautiful acai bowl. Yum.
Romp it.
Is it good?
It's half decent.
Half decent.
No, it's fire.
Better than what you can make at home.
It's some filet mignon.
Max, show us your neighborhood.
Oh, yes, it's my backyard.
Max's apartment is...
What up, Chris?
Up there.
Are you playing today? It's beautiful out. Look at this. Day in the life of me. I work right there at the life.
I found
this hat at the beach. Do you guys like it?
It's a girl hat.
It's really cool.
Okay.
We got all the uncles playing bocce ball. Oh, that's a good bocce game right there.
First Passover of the weekend. We have a full family weekend.
Grandma Lochi and Grandpa Bob's.
Oh. Here's ready for
whole
the welcome.
A whole lot you're of action so... here to come.
Here we are.
You're so
it's Passover.
You're
Passover.
So
and hello.
Oh, we're yeah.
Oh, dear.
Look at this.
Oh, my.
And even move? Max, huh?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Jesus Christ. Yeah. Quit growing, will you? You'll.
Hello, man.
Hello, girl.
How's it going?
Hey, I'm doing
Hi,
good.
Grandpa.
Yeah, I'm so happy to see you. Hanna, I love you.
She's almost taller than you. Go back to back real quick.
He just passed his
dang.
PWC, which is...
only like an inch, half an inch, 2 inches.
He like that.
Look, here's our table. Beautiful table. Nice house.
Yeah. Good grandma just gave me.
That's pretty styling.
How rad is this?
I'm gonna take a shot with me. Isn't that great?
That's
I love that.
Three generations strong. Smile.
Hey, I'm always smiling. It's the agave in me.
It's the agave.
It's the
agave gene.
So Hornito is right. Big boy, isn't he?
Yeah.
You and Hornitos go way back.
Oh, hell yeah. Ooh, yeah, boys
right.
And girls, L'chaim, all the best, and can we do this again? Yes!
Absolutely.
Yes! Cheers. Mm. Happy Passover.
Passover, round two.
Mariska.
This is my grandma's house. Her little garden. Hi!
Vloggy!
Whoa, vloggy!
Max is vlogging.
Hi.
I got
It's Passover. She's the cutest ever, and she's just gonna introduce herself and give you a fun fact.
Well, first of all, I'm Bianca. I'm 15, almost 16 soon. Mm-hmm. And I was born in Hawaii.
Yay!
And we moved here when I was like 4.
So you were born in Hawaii.
Yeah.
And that's a fun fact about you. What's like, so what grade are you in right now?
I'm in 10th grade, so I'm a sophomore.
Yeah. And she basically did this whole year, guys.
Online.
Which is crazy. Mm-hmm. It's just so difficult nowadays. Like, she had no contact with friends at school. Like, it was just such a different dynamic. But you're back at school now.
Kind of. Partially.
Yeah, partially back.
Like, twice a week right now.
Right.
I've only been, though, one day so far. Last week.
Yeah. And what's, like, the best thing about being back at school for you?
Well, definitely my first two classes, because my teachers are, like, definitely very energy from, like, being in the classroom with other kids, and since there's kids in the classroom, they're more, like, engaging, and it's nice to, like,
learning better.
Yeah, it's nice to, like, talk instead of just, like, being unmuted, like, muted and just saying, like, whatever you want to say about, like, whatever the
topic
is.
Right, it's not as interactive.
Yeah.
So, definitely, I think, like, having this holiday, having Passover, and spending time with the family, I think, like, obviously I get to connect a lot more with my cousin, Bianca, and just learn a lot more about, like, her generation and just what everyone's going through right now during this time. I think it really has definitely given me a different perspective, because a lot of times we're in our own little world with all that's going on, and, like, this year has had a lot of highs and a lot of lows for all of us, but it's definitely interesting for me. And what I've enjoyed about having Passover back home is just really learning about, you know, how other people have dealt with this year, because we definitely haven't seen each other in like a year, which is wild.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, well, we're gonna go back and enjoy our drinks and have Passover with all the old people. Am I old?
Hanna's gonna leave this town.
Oh, Dad, you're so sad.
I'm sad.
Aw, Dad.
Hi.
Hi, Bobby. Oh, you got it.
No, I'll roll.
Oh, you got it, Dennis.
That's right.
Good morning, guys. It is the next day. I am feeling really groggy and tired today. I spent the entire day yesterday at the beach with my brother and my cousin. It was really fun. Just watched him play some volleyball and got to really enjoy kind of just like my last final beach day. San Diego blessed us with some good weather today, or yesterday, I guess, and I guess this next few days, honestly. It's like, it was almost 80 degrees yesterday, super warm. It was like a summer day. So many people out at the beach, which I know it was like interesting during these times, but it's really nice at the beach because you're able to kind of park up and like distance yourself from other people and still enjoy some sun and salt water on your hair. So it was a really good day. I didn't vlog too much while my brother was down there, but then we also had a picnic, which you probably just saw some of that footage from. Just one last final like picnic with some of my family members, just to say goodbye to them. My aunt and uncle drove down from LA, so that was really nice to get to see them. Anyways, I was up pretty early at like 6:30 this morning, but now it's 9:20. I am running to my second sugaring appointment. So you would have seen in an old vlog that I started to get sugared, which was really great, actually. I don't know that I ever gave an update, but it was really nice because it took over a month for my hair to actually grow back, which was really nice that I didn't have to shave that whole time. So I really enjoyed it, and I'm really interested to see now how the second time goes around. So I'm going to go get that done. I also have to go get a COVID test today because I am flying to New York in 2 days, and I've been reading mixed reviews about whether you need a test upon arrival or not. They're saying now that there's some exceptions being made for people who were vaccinated, and I know it's kind of controversial, but I actually ended up being able to be fully vaccinated while I was home, so I do have my vaccination card. So I'm just gonna go get a test just in case, because I decided super last minute to go to New York and visit a friend. I really feel like now is the time before I move to just kind of see all my friends and spend time as much as I can with my friends. So I'm really looking forward to the trip, but I have to kind of like, I have to buy my flight today. I haven't even bought my flight yet, and go get a test. So I'm doing that. And then I'm also getting another facial. And this time I'm paying for it myself. My parents gifted me a facial last time, but this time I definitely just wanted to get one last facial in, especially before I fly and I have a lot of travel coming up, and I just feel like my skin could definitely use it. So I have a pretty packed day of like errands I'm gonna take you along with, but other than that, that's just a little update. I literally leave in 2 days, so I'm gonna be packing up and just getting my stuff together and showing you guys that. But my week has been crazy. I've definitely been feeling extremely bittersweet. Like, I think I had a moment last night where I kind of cried a little bit in bed, because as excited as I am to finally reunite with George and move to England, it's a huge move. I've always lived like 2 hours away from my home. When I lived in San Diego, I moved and went to school in LA, and that was only like a 2-hour drive. So I always knew that if I needed to come home for any reason, my parents were home, or they could come up if there was an emergency. So this is definitely a big move. It's a life move. I'm moving to a whole new country, and it's kind of starting to sink in with me. And I'm getting a little emotional about it, honestly. I'm super close to my family, and it's definitely gonna be tough to leave them, but I do know. And what George keeps reminding me is that they're just a flight away, and if I ever need to come visit them, I'm very privileged in the fact that we can make that happen. So he's trying to reassure me, but it's been definitely a bittersweet week and lots of emotions going on. Anyways, I'm gonna stop rambling. I'm gonna go get my sugar and then go get my COVID test, and then I'll check back in with you guys later. So rough. Don't mind my breakout, but I just wanted to get on here and say this is what moving to a different country looks like. I cannot even begin to tell you the stress right now that I have and all this more to pack. It's a mess, and truthfully, I'm bringing this big giant suitcase, which half is packed with clothes already, in this little suitcase, and that's all I'm bringing to England. So it's been tough trying to fit everything, and if you think I can get them all into the two, we will check back in later, but I'm stressed. Okay guys, I spent the whole day packing. It wasn't without a little stress and a few tears, right, Jennifer?
Right.
It was a little tough. I will show you what I managed to do, but basically my suitcase that I'm checking cannot be over 50 pounds. These are the bags I'm taking. That's my backpack. That's stuff I unfortunately have to leave because it will not fit. And then I'm taking that bag there too as another carry-on. So everything is ready to go. And let's just pray that this big boy here is 50 pounds. Otherwise, I'm gonna have to pay $100. Little girl's leaving. Say bye.
Not a good day.
Bye, Hannah.
Bye.
See you on the other coast.
I'll miss you guys.
Thank you.
raise them up so they can take off.
Just another night. Love ya. Across the sky.
Miss you.
Bye. Say bye. Put your hand over the camera. Bye.
Bye.